Central Division rivalry set to unfold. Capital One Hockey Night on Versus. It's the Blues and Blackhawks inside of a boisterous United Center in Chicago, where the home team hasn't been at home for quite some time. Patrick Kane, Jonathan Taves, and friends all dressed in red to square off with the St. Louis Blues. Ty Conklin gets to go in nets for Davis Payne as they spell Yaroslav Halak. At the opposite end, Corey Crawford has been hot of late. He'll keep Marty Turco on the bench for this evening as these two meet for the third time this regular season. The action unfolds for you in high definition. Nicholas Jarmerson to get it started. Victor Stahlberg got it only as far as the St. Louis line. Barrett Jackman on patrol there. A stalwart defensively for St. Louis when healthy. Backus will regroup, forced by Stahlberg, and Petrangelo will give some ground. Backus cut off by Jarmerson. At the line, Sobotka not going very far. Campbell will pepper it back to center as these two teams play in the neutral zone. Backus to fire, glove save Crawford, and he'll hold on. Your Craftsman tools for success. Edzo, we're looking at keys to the game tonight.
Well, for the Blackhawks coming off that six-game road trip, got to do better on the penalty kill. They've given up goals in four straight games. Got to improve on that and talk about the identity of the St. Louis Blues. Play hard, shift to shift. For the Blackhawks, we talked about in the open, got to start making some hay here at home.
Two teams that split their first two meetings back in October. As you see the line combinations at the top of your screen, you won't see the name Marian Hossa in the lineup for Chicago. Injured in practice yesterday, an accidental collision with Nick Boynton, landing Hossa on the shelf, Joel Quenneville saying, for upwards of 2 to 3 weeks with a lower body injury.
Second time Hossa's been out for extended period. Heard a little bit earlier in the season as well.
Blues putting some pressure on. Alex Steen cradles one to the front. Deflected away from Boys. Steen gathers in. Poke check by Duncan Keith. Andy McDonald, the speedster, working on the perimeter. He gets knocked down. Duncan Keith leads the NHL in ice time. Gets the center stripe. Sends it hard around as both teams are in the midst of personnel changes. Jay McClement, forced by Tomas Paketski. Kopetsky in the lineup, working on with different linemen. Jeremy Morin, 27, brought in from American Hockey League Rockford during the day today. The 19-year-old in Joel Quenneville's lineup right there, strong on the forecheck. Kopetsky there to support. This one tumbles back to center where Boynton will regroup. 2 minutes down in a scoreless first period. Loop back out to center. Seabrook. Hearing the footsteps of Cam Jansen approaching. Jansen will always finish his checks.
Mom and Dad are in from St. Louis for the trip.
D'Agostini, good look. Saved there from Crawford as he stepped out on the angle. Taking care of that bid from Porter. Chris Porter knifing behind defender. Conklin starts the breakout himself for the Blues. St. Louis and Chicago separated by 1 point in the Central Division standings. Dowell leaves it on the capable stick of Duncan Keith, last year's Norris Trophy winner. Sending out Patrick Kane on the fly. Kane working down the boards. Petrangelo cut him off. Great look, and it was shanked by Campbell. Backus speeds to the loose puck and lobs it high back onto the Chicago side of center. Campbell is an effortless skater. Connecting with Taves through center. Jonathan Taves, 3-on-3. That pass just a little too slow for Kane. Sobotka counterattacking, and this one's blistered wide by Backus. Backus from glove to stick. Berglund operates in the corner. Sobotka, point position. Petrangelo lets it fly, and that was deadened by Stahlberg. It broke his stick.
Two two-on-ones for the St. Louis Blues. All started because of good, quick decisions in the middle of the ice.
Bickle working the boards. Down the alleyway for Brouwer. Long wrister, kick save. Old school there from Conklin. Brouwer digging in. Johnson knocked down Bickle. Fans wanting the call, none from either referee. A turnover here. Quick release. Mickle shouldered aside by Conklin. Seabrook lets it go. That's deflected wide.
Go, go!
Steen relieving the pressure. On a long outlet, McDonald has a step, and then he's erased by Seabrook. Five-on-five action continues. Bolin for the Blackhawks to center. Drives it in. Chicago wants the change. Quickly, 4.5 minutes down. Shots on goal, level at 2 apiece. Kopetsky fires, he scores!
Well, after two outstanding opportunities for the St. Louis Blues, the Chicago Blackhawks create a chance. A good forecheck there by Jeremy Morin, Patrick Sharp to Thomas Kopetsky. And I believe this puck goes right between the legs of Ty Conklin. But the initial forecheck. I don't know if Carlo Koliakovo got a piece of that puck or not, Joe, when he was trying to be in desperation mode to deflect that puck. I'm not sure if he changed direction or not.
Third goal of the year, Edzo, for Kopetsky. Just his second in the month of November. Giving the locals the advantage. First game back after a six-game road swing while the circus was in town here at United Center. Jeremy Morin will clear it in. Ty Conklin, earlier in his career, surrendered a two-goal game to Kopetsky, who put Chicago on the board tonight. Now Pietrangelo. Still developing his seasoning in St. Louis. Great look for Porter. And Crawford, staying nice and square, makes the stop. The gloves are down. It's Scott and Jansen. Scott with the long reach. He pummeled LA's Kevin Westgarth over the weekend. He's sticking it to Cam Jansen.
Jansen with a good left. Jansen tried to get in real tight. He knows he doesn't have the advantage reach-wise.
Both of these guys throwing bombs. Jansen's a rugged customer. Strong chin. Saying, come on, let's go, come on! Stamina on Jansen to keep firing late. Linesman giving him a long leash. And then finally, McKelman and Pancic. The linesman will separate those two.
Well, right after Chris Porter, second good chance for Porter. Coming down the right wing boards. Jansen and Scott disrobe. And right away, you watch Jansen get in tight on Big John Scott. Both players landed a couple. I think Scott got the better of the bigger shots there, Joe, but Jansen's great endurance and got in tight and got a couple pops in as well.
Jansen fighting a man there some 8 inches taller than himself, 6'8", John Scott. Joel Quenneville and the Blackhawks entertaining the Blues tonight. 5 minutes and 24 seconds in. Chicago already on the lead at 4:38. Kopetsky's third of the season. Chicago team that's desperately trying to pick up the paces at home. Taves motoring for center. Chicago under 500 at home, offside on the rush. We send you down ringside. Sarah Kustak has more on John Scott.
Well, Joe, you had mentioned that fight with John Scott on Saturday night, who left the Los Angeles Kings Kevin Westgarth bloody face. And you know what? Scott stands 6'8" tall, and he gave up his fighting technique. He said, you know what? Most of the time these guys can't reach me. The height works to my advantage. I have long arms, so I'm kind of like a monkey-armed bamboo swinging away. So, however you want, but Scott certainly gets the job done.
Jansen in various stages of undress over in the penalty box. Members of the operations staff at United Center tending to a pane of plexiglass. 1-0 Chicago, early going. It was Kopetsky's third of the year from sharp at 4:38. Folks, it's Capital One Hockey Night on Versus. Monday, 7:30. Showdown in the West, the Sharks and the Red Wings. Then Tuesday at 7, division rivals, Sabres and Bruins will be facing off. Hockey Lives on Versus.
That was a good look at head coach Davis Payne. I asked him today with all the injuries, especially up front, David Perron, TJ Oshie, Roman Polak, who I think is a terrific young defenseman. Talk about the stable of the St. Louis Blues. Asked about anybody that's really stepped up. It's kind of been more by committee. I talked to John Davidson, the president of the St. Louis Blues. We felt that Andy McDonald's been the most consistent forward all season long for Davis Payne and the Blues.
Andy McDonald, who paces the team in terms of goals and points. Seabrook will skip it in. Brower to the end wall. Koliakovo keeps it moving. Boys lost the handle.
Mentioned Andy McDonald's. This is his first game at center ice all season long. His natural center ice position. Blues want to try to spread the wealth a little bit.
Backes is playing a lot of his time at center on that highly productive line. Davis Payne said the top line's been carrying us for a little bit too long. Need to spread the wealth out a little bit. Keith to Bickle.
Probably think on that point, Joe, I think Backes is probably better. You know, they on the wall. They got a chance to see him. He can certainly fill in and do it. But moving forward, I think the Blues see him as being that guy to be on the wall.
Backes a big body, a guy who loves the body contest. Blues trying to get some momentum out of their own zone. Nearing the 7-minute mark of this first period, 1-0 Chicago. Nikita. Nikitin on the dump in. Nikitin, the 24-year-old Russian. Morin. Forced back by Crombie. McClement gets in the act at center. Eric Johnson keeping it on the perimeter. Winchester, another very big body, did not get it deep.
I thought Winchester had a little bit more time there. Once the puck came from Eric Johnson, made a good play. Winchester, you got to just take a quick look over his shoulder, see where the pressure is. There's no pressure coming.
Sharp eludes Porter. Finds Kopetsky on the wing. And Porter was right with him shoulder to shoulder. Conklin helping his own cause as the Blues come barreling out of their own end.
Such a big help for defense when you have goaltenders that are able to make those good, smart decisions.
It sounds like Corey Crawford's getting better at it from watching Marty Turco.
Yeah, Stefan Waite's done a tremendous job, the goaltending coach. And yeah, you can learn a lot by just watching a veteran guy like Turco play that puck.
Speed game now for Stahlberg down the wing. Hits the brakes. Petrangelo flies by. Centering pass for Campbell. Just out of reach. Counter-attacking, back come the Blues with Backes. 2-on-2, fires, and it's a blocker save. Crawford can't find the rebound as it tumbles behind the net. Hjalmarsson to center.
Nice back check there by Victor Stahlberg, allowed Nicholas Hjalmarsson to come all the way over on David Backes. So it was another mini 2-on-1 that turned into 2-on-2 because of a good back check by Stahlberg.
Crawford covers up. We hang out for a moment. Thomas Kopetsky in Chicago, giving the Hawks the advantage early on. Regular season. This is Capital One Hockey Night on Versus. Chicago, a 1-0 advantage over visiting St. Louis. And Eddie, the Blackhawks have given the crease to a rookie consistently now.
Yeah, right now, and you see the four straight wins for Corey Crawford. Last time was done by Eddie Belfour, but he's a couple games away from the rookie record. How about Panger? Darren Pang did it way back in 87-88. Who won 7 consecutive starts as a rookie. Of course, Darren Pang, the local analyst in St. Louis for the Blues. And always good to get Panger in the broadcast.
Attaboy, Darren. Jonathan Toews, muzzled by Eric Johnson, goes crashing into the goal. Referees are letting the boys play. Denny LaRue and Brian Pocmara wearing the orange armbands tonight. Berglund trying to pitchfork it free, along with the help of Backes. Stahlberg rotates to the front. That one hit him right in the skate. Hjalmarsson teaming up with Patrick Kane. Stahlberg's backhand was a weak one, wide of the net. Point position, Hjalmarsson. This way for Campbell, just out of his grasp. Blues looking to clear. Backes deflects it on out, and Hjalmarsson will rewind.
Well, you saw Brian Campbell coming down that weak side. A lot of confidence going on right now for the Blackhawk defenseman. You're a blue forward. You better have your head on a swivel and know where the defensemen are. They're not afraid to come into the cycle and get involved offensively.
St. Louis in the visiting white. Eric Johnson wants to get up ice tonight himself. Be more of a scoring factor. The offensive totals for number six for the Blues, not where they normally are. Koliakovo at center. Boys gave it up. Duncan Keith. Back paired up with Brent Seabrook. Those two were reunited in Southern California on Friday. Such a formidable duo last year in Chicago's Stanley Cup run. McClement freezing down the wing. EJ Crombean there to support. Stick check by Sharp. Good takeaway. Jeremy Morin dodging the hit of Barrett Jackman. Petrangelo. Davis Payne, his head coach, says he's a playmaker now for this team. More and more comfortable at the NHL level.
I think it helps, too, playing with a veteran guy like Barrett Jackman. Petrangelo's so smart, so smooth, just gaining more and more confidence with the role he's been given by the Blues coaching staff.
Physically ready, more mentally prepared for the rigors of the NHL game. As we hit 9 minutes to go in the opening period. One of five on the slate tonight in the NHL. Back at Hockey Central, Bill Keith, Ryan, and special guest Mike Milbury keeping an eye on the other goings-on. Rauer works the cycle. Takeaway, Petrangelo. Sobotka, the former Bruin, working down the wing. Keith staying with him stride for stride. This one's chiseled away. Back through center on the fly. Jack Skilly spun around and down.
Good stick there by Matt D'Agostini, the forward backing up. And allow Johnson to come back with that real long reach.
Got to be a good sign for the Blues. D'Agostini, they want him to be better in his defensive end. Brewer waiting for this one. Golfs it ahead. Kane looking to Stahlberg. Patrick Kane, backhander, missed it on the short side. Backus hooking up with Berglund through center to the front, and on patrol waiting for that was Brian Campbell. Chicago's captain Jonathan Toews was swarmed at center. We get a whistle, the stoppage in play.
Might be a penalty coming up here, Joe.
We'll be back with a call after these words.
Welcome back to the first period here with Blues head coach Davis Payne. Coach, the Hawks get on the board first, but you talked to us earlier about supporting those attack opportunities. What have you seen out of your team offensively?
Well, it was a little bit tough on the start there. We lost our outlet and Carlo Tripp behind the net, unfortunately down one, but we're getting some chances. We're getting some good offensive push, and our transition game's been pretty sharp about finding some opportunities to attack with some vertical play.
All right, thanks so much, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.
Joe?
Davis and Sarah, we appreciate it. Patrick Kane in the box, 2 minutes for hooking. That was the call on the way to commercial break. Boys, Backus, D'Agostini, Petrangelo, and Steen, five on ice for St. Louis. Win of the draw gets it back to the point. Bowling very aggressively there with a strip and the clear. St. Louis in its last three games, over six on the power play, as you see the special teams numbers overall. St. Louis hovering around 14% on the campaign. Seabrook didn't get it out. Petrangelo chisels it into the corner. D'Agostini for Backus and then Boyce. Pressure coming on the outside from Jake Dowell. D'Agostini shielding it from two defenders. Boyce challenged by Seabrook, who wins the board battle and sends it on back to center. Just over 7 minutes to go. 1-0 Chicago thanks to Tomas Kopetsky. Seabrook had this one click off of a forechecker. Petrangelo serves it to the front. Boyce, one more to McDonald. His pass intercepted. And Sharp goes the other way. Very dangerous shorthand on a crisscross with Toews. Sharp in the last five seasons for himself. 14 shorthanded goals. This will be an area where Chicago would miss the services of Marian Hossa. Equally dangerous, a man down. You watch Carlo Koliakovo set sail through center. McDonald gets the entry into the zone. Eric Johnson canceled out. Campbell there. Jarmuson flexes it back. Good keep in. Berglund, 20 seconds to operate on the power play. Four-player scrum. Swatted into the far corner. Berglund in a foot race with Brower, and boom, they go to the boards. Oliakovo for Berglund. He fanned on it as he was ready to pull the trigger. Winchester's the big man. They camp out in front to set screens. Kane is set free from the box. Good penalty kill by Chicago. Oliakovo finding Eric Johnson. Back behind the net. Jarmuson there. A bad clear. Oliakovo fires, and Crawford was able to eat that up.
Joe, you made mention of Troy Brower with that big hit on Patrick Berglund. Berglund laid it on the line there. He knew he was going to get hit to make the play. He was able to get the puck back to the point.
Kane zips into the zone. One touch passing, and Coughlin with a stop on Sharp. 5:17 to go in the opening period. Blues, Blackhawks, good old friends in Chicago.
I'm Bill Patrick. Ahead on the Pizza Hut intermission report, it was an interesting night for Sidney Crosby last night in New York. Some Rangers players are not happy with him. We'll tell you why and whether they're right to be upset. Join me, Keith Jones, Brian Engblom, and Mike Milbury for that and more coming up between periods. Joe?
Things got a little edgy for Sidney and friends an evening ago. Mentioned there are four other games going on. Tampa Bay is in Toronto tonight at Air Canada Center with the Leafs have won three in a row. Long blast wide of Conklin from point position from Campbell. Tampa Bay in town, and the Bolts have done just fine in Toronto. They've won eight of their last 12. 5 minutes separating us from that Pizza Hut intermission report. Thomas Kopetsky and the Blackhawks have a 1-0 advantage. Two teams skating 5-on-5 as Kopetsky gets cleaned out in the corner.
Chris Porter, boy, he's had a strong first period.
Chris Porter, 26-year-old Toronto native, flexing his muscles.
Original Chicago draft pick.
10th choice, way back in the 03 draft. Stahlberg on the move, good poke check. Well timed there by Eric Johnson. Brewer with Bolin nearby. Expect a lot of body contacts between these two teams. The Blues-Blackhawks rivalry rekindled in recent years. Some would say it never went away. And playing in an ultra-competitive Central Division. We talked to Davis Payne. He says, if you're not on your game on any particular night, it's over. Boys dumps it in. McDonald's the first man to it. Duncan Keith was there to cover him up. Not a lot of shots in this first period. Unofficially 5-4. Favor St. Louis. Kane open up. Drinks one wide. Taves. Good moves in open ice. Then he fumbled it. Barrett Jackman able to get it clear. Jason Cullimore on the hand-to-head. Stahlberg did not thread that through Jackman.
Got lucky there. Turn that puck over. He had three guys going one way. Get that puck in deep late in the period.
3:20 left in it. Boynton did not keep that in. It is offside against Chicago as we check in with Sarah Kusta.
Well, Joe, you guys have been talking about the big loss for the Hawks with Marian Hossa being out, and Jeremy Morin was then recalled by the team to help fill his place. We saw the initial forecheck he made that led to that Thomas Kopetsky goal, but I talked to the 19-year-old earlier today, asked him about filling in for Hossa, and he said, you know what, I don't look at it like that. My job is to play within my own capabilities, and our team as a whole has to fill in for Hossa's absence.
Basically, he was saying that he doesn't look at this like he has huge shoes to fill. Right in here, backdoor score! Berglund!
Well, it was just a matter of time and an odd man situation for the St. Louis Blues. Barrett Jackman to David Backes to Sobotka to Patrick Berglund, but a simple little play. Great patience. And with the stick of Jason Cullimore on the ice, slows it up and up. And from our Jack Daniels goal cam, you see Patrick Berglund elevate the puck. But a simple play. You heard Davis Payne tell Sarah Kustak about the decision-making in the neutral zone. Quick heads up. Backus draws a couple Blackhawk defenders, and in a simple little play, Joe, a two-on-one from about 35 feet out. But how about the patience by Sobotka? Wait, wait, wait. And then look for Berglund on that off wing. Left-handed shot coming down the right wing boards and was able to elevate the puck over Corey Crawford.
Sobotka, they always loved his stick skills in Boston. Made a fine pass there. Leading to Berglund, sixth of the year at 16:59. Just the second time in 13 games against Chicago that Berglund has dented the twine. This is an offside, an intentional offside against St. Louis. 1-1 here, and we can take a look at John Scott going awkwardly into the boards.
Going over to finish a check on Alex Pietrangelo. Kind of laboring through that last shift. You know, what St. Louis has done to this point in the first period, a lot of their opportunities, Joe, have come from the quick transition. Not up the boards, but it's been right to the middle of the ice. And that's how they've gotten really three two-on-ones. Capitalize on that last one by Berglund.
Edzo, the players and coaches were saying the same thing, that they wanted to attack the interior, be less of a perimeter club tonight.
More times than not, it starts on the outside, and then you work your way up. First of all, you have to have support in order to do that, and then you have to have the ability to be able to make those passes.
2:05 to play in this opening period. 1-1, Blues and Blackhawks. Kopensky and Berglund exchanging markers. Third meeting of six between the Central Division rivals. They split a pair of games 4 days apart back in October. Brower and Boland were dangerous at the attacking line. Now it's a counterattack for St. Louis. Backus to the front. And on patrol there was Brower. Sprinting to keep it in. Good job, Koliakovo fires, and it's vacuumed up by Crawford. Chicago would dearly love to have Marian Hossa's services tonight. They're not going to have him for quite a while.
An opportunity for somebody else, as Sarah told us about Jeremy Morin. We'll get a chance to see Marian Hossa. Not only what he does offensively, but playing in those key situations, killing penalties out there at the end of games. I don't think there's a better player in National Hockey that pursues the puck than a guy like Marian Hossa.
This guy right here, Patrick Kane, was saying he's learned from Marian Hossa about that back pressure, trying to be a better defensive player in his own right. When you think of Hossa, you think of him as being one of the best two-way guys in the league.
Yeah, that never-give-up attitude and always knowing and having in his mind is never too late to come back in a play. But it's also the speed of Marian Hossa, Joe. It's also, when you're the puck carrier, you want options. But he has that uncanny ability to be able to take away. If you got three of them, you probably don't have any by the time that Marian Hossa gets on you because of his speed and also his stick, his active stick. He takes it away. He puts you in a spot that he knows that he has a very good chance of forcing a turnover. So it's an opportunity for somebody else. And as we saw on the graphic, he missed five games earlier in the season. He just come off a real strong game the other night against the Los Angeles Kings.
So many coaches preach that. We were talking with Davis Payne earlier today. He wanted to take away the passing lanes, take away shooting lanes, just be that conscientious in the defensive zone. An odd man rush potential here. Sharp and Kopensky two-on-one. Sharp off the head fake. Backhand score! Patrick Sharp.
Look at the effort there by Jeremy Moore, forcing Barrett Jackman with the turnover. Brian Campbell stops it, and that's a two-on-one. Forehand, backhand, beats Ty Conklin. But Thomas Kopensky going to the net. He draws Alex Pietrangelo over a little bit. And once Pietrangelo moves over to take away the pass, that's the sign that he's leaving the shooter for his goaltender. And Patrick Sharp recognized that. Just a little move, just a quick little move. But Patrick Sharp absolutely on fire and getting right back on the ice. But watch the move coming up. Patrick Sharp's going to move. Now watch Pietrangelo defensive. Watch the fake, and now Pietrangelo goes down, and he drifts away. Sharp recognizes that, takes the puck to the net, and is rewarded. But Warren forced the turnover by Jackman very late in this first.
Long slapper from Seabrook, steered to the corner by Conklin. 40 seconds left to work in this opening period. 2-1 for Chicago. Sharp, a team leading 16th, shooting and skating with so much confidence now. Six goals in his last seven games. Kane hits the brakes, works the cycle for Sharp. Keith, switch it up. Seabrook on a slap pass. It's deflected out of play by Kane. Sharp climbing the ranks when it comes to goal leaders in the NHL.
Oh, what a year for Steven Stamkos. Some likely companions up there with Sidney Crosby and Alexander Semin and Patrick Sharp, as we said, got off to a great start, 10 in his first 11, then hit a little bit of a dry patch. He was absolutely on fire right now.
So far ahead of his pace of last season when he provided 25 goals. 4 seconds, now three. Berglund's blast is blocked, and that will do it for one-third of regulation at United Center. 20 minutes complete. Central Division rivals squaring off. Sharp and Kopetsky bookending goals around a strike from Berglund. After the break, we'll have the Pizza Hut intermission report. Back to Hockey Central. Bill Keith, Brian, and Mike Filbury. After these words. Blues and Blackhawks have played 20 minutes of Capital One Hockey Night On versus Chicago, back at home and with a 2-1 lead. Joe Beninati and Eddie Olczyk with you. And Eddie, that lead goal for the Blackhawks, a man who doesn't get an assist yet, made quite a play, and that was Brian Campbell.
We're going to get him an assist because he deserves it. Jeremy Morin, who's been instrumental on both goals, does a good job of forechecking. But there's Brian Campbell. Barrett Jackman does not get this puck in deep. The stick of Brian Campbell knocks it out of midair. It goes right to Thomas Kopetsky. He gets it to Patrick Sharp. The little shake and bake. Forehand, backhand. And the Blackhawks with a late goal.
Eddie, you mentioned the value of the head fake and the stick fake there for Sharp, fooling Pietrangelo. If you're a young defenseman, if you're Pietrangelo, if you're a Bantam player, what are you supposed to do on that two-on-one?
Well, you are trying to make sure that that puck does not go backdoor. And I think Pietrangelo did that, but I don't think he had to move that far. But again, you got to know who has the puck as well, Joe. It's Patrick Sharp, no player really hotter as of late. So maybe, you know what, you force him to move the puck to Thomas Kopetsky. Now, saying that, Kopetsky had the first goal of the game against his former teammate when they played in Detroit, Ty Conklin.
Off we go in period two. Barrett Jackman out there for St. Louis. A lead for Sobotka, who set up the St. Louis tally back in period one. Berglund's sixth of the year. Two teams are working at full and even strength. Brad Boys will dump it in. Corey Crawford in net for Chicago. Ty Conklin at the other end for St. Louis. Steam fires, and it's right to the glove of Crawford. The Progressive Insurance storyline plays out like this, Eddie.
Well, Thomas Kopetsky, as we mentioned, beating his former teammate when they were in Detroit. And then a beautiful play there by Vladimir Sobotka, and then to Patrick Berglund, and then another Patrick Sharp. 2-1 lead going into second.
Blues continuing to play without David Perron, who was dynamite against Chicago in the two games back in October. Had 4 goals in those two games. And most definitely would have been very close to the top of Joel Quenneville's scouting list had he been available tonight. Still suffering from the concussion sustained to that hit with Joe Thornton. As we have a penalty call here. Referees tonight, Denny LaRue and Brian Pokmara.
Looks like it's going to be on Eric Johnson. It's going to be an elbow. Yeah, right at the last second, he had shoulder lined up, and then just that lift of the elbow.
Chicago won its last two games on the road. Won 4 out of 6 on that lengthy road swing away from the Windy City. Thomas Kopetsky with his third of the year from Sharp starting the scoring tonight. And Jonathan Toews, who's Chicago's third leading point producer, didn't lose a faceoff in the first period. He was 6-0. was beaten there. Petrangelo didn't get it out. Last three games for the Blackhawks, 0-9 with a man advantage. Seabrook finding Taves to the interior. Petrangelo able to bounce it past Seabrook. 21.6% effective now is Chicago in the top 10 in the NHL. Kane darting into the offensive zone. Patrick Kane turns the corner, mauled there by Brewer. Bounces right back to Kane. Skip a man for Sharp. Sharp and Seabrook at the points. Kane works a two-man game rotation down low. Swing and a miss for Sharp. Backes barreling his way through center. David Backes looking for the late man. Centering pass. And Brewer just chiseled it high. Dangerous again. Short side save Crawford. He beat Berglund. Stretch play out there for Brouwer. Too far. Petrangelo touches it up. It's icing against Chicago. Blackhawks still on a power play for another 52 seconds.
Well, a good chance for the St. Louis Blues shorthanded. Outstanding. Puck possession there by David Backes looking for Eric Brewer coming in while shorthanded. And right before that chance, Kane to Taze to Patrick Sharp. Weak side. There was a breakdown in coverage by the St. Louis Blues. Good active stick in front, but Sharp was a little bit too open for the Blues liking.
Eric Brewer, the captain of the Blues since 08. More than 700 NHL games now on his ledger. You don't often see him there way up on the play. Brouwer hiding behind the defense. Leaves it in his wake. Jeremy Morin, the 19-year-old, over skates. McClement down the dasher board. Poke checked by Brian Campbell. Morin to dump it in. Strange bounce right to the front. And a layup.
Well, the dump in by Jeremy Morin takes a fortunate Blackhawk bounce right off the stanchion. And Joe, you asked me about a young defenseman playing a two-on-one. More times than not, if you're a goaltender and the puck is in the glass, you stay home. If it's around the boards, more times than not, you're going to come out of your crease and stop it. But that puck was on edge one. Two, it was in the glass. Conklin thought he was going to be able to stop and help out his D. You know what he's trying to do. But in that situation, you got to stay home. And Brouwer's there for a wide open net.
An easy power play goal, if you will. That'll help your percentages. Brouwer sending away Bolin down the wing. Koliakovo reels him in, takes him down. Penalty coming up. Blues are going shorthanded after the trip.
Well, a little stutter step there by Dave Bolin. We heard Jonesy talk about Dave Bolin back at Hockey Central before this game. Off to a tough start. The last couple games has played better. And there does a nice little change of speed there and forces Koliakovo to take a penalty.
Boys got into a pretty good debate on whether or not Sidney Crosby's slew foot should be drawing as much ire as it is from the New Yorkers. Chicago to the man advantage. Sharp softly down the wing for Taves. He relays for Kopetsky, who golfed it wide. Kane shimmies out of the corner. Back on top for Seabrook. Sharp challenged by McClement. King steps to the net. Backdoor. Good save Conklin as he beats Sharp's one-timer. Sharp delivers to Seabrook. Moves the puck back to the top goal scorer. Then King gets the middle and fires. That was stopped by Conklin. He got it off the thin portion of his goalie stick. Good keep in by King. Chicago threatening on the power play. Patrick Kane spins to the backhand. Tried to make one more clever pass. Sobotka was in the way. He and McClement go two on two. McClement fires. That was routine for Corey Crawford. Crawford has been excellent in each of his last six outings. Two goals or less. Talked with Marty Turco earlier today. And Turco nodded the head, said Corey should be playing right now. He's hot. And the team is benefiting as a result.
Even though Chicago's only two games over 500, Joe. It hasn't been because of the goaltending for the most part. Yeah, there's been some bad goals, and you know, goaltenders are going to give those up. The goaltending has been the least of the problems for the Blackhawks this year.
Berglund angling out of his own zone with Backes on a little give and go. Campbell was in the way. Brower back for Chicago. 18 seconds left in the man advantage. Brower winds and fires. A blocker pad save for Conklin.
He's made three really good stops in this power play.
Brower drifting below the goal line. Stokes it on back for Duncan Keith. Brower then dummies it all the way on through to Bolin in the far corner. They move it for Campbell. Keith's one-timer. That knuckled a bit. Berglund was in the shooting lane. Blues do the job on the penalty kill. And now Brewer comes racing back through center. With Alex Steen, he fires. A stick save for Crawford. Lively boards and glass inside of United Center. Both teams were practicing that this morning. At times, shooting intentionally wide. Skilly, sharp angle. Crombie put a shoulder on him. D'Agostini to Nikitin. And the return for D'Agostini to send down as the Blues will change on the go.
Talked about those active boards. We saw that last night at Versus in Carolina with James Neal taking a shot in the puck. Just Joe Louis-like, I like to say. Just ricocheted right back to him and put it behind Cam Ward.
Few rinks in the league as lively as Joe Louis. The puck's like a pinball there. Skilly charging ahead off the pump fake. Skilly throws it blindly to the front, just out of the reach of the big winger, Scott, who had a spirited fight with Cam Jansen back in the first. Porter is there to throw his weight around. Chicago, long clear, onside Brower. Fires, that's over the shoulder and high. Joel Quenneville changing up on the go. Alex Pietrangelo for St. Louis to Barrett Jackman. And then McDonald carving through center. Dished it into the corner. Duncan Keith will play it on around. Brower on the board on the power play. A fluke goal to start the second period scoring. Bickle leaves it below the goal line. Jackman on a quick reverse. Back in business in the lineup after missing a bunch of games with a knee injury. Steen gets stalled at the attacking line. That sends away Taze. Closing in, fires! And Conklin got just enough. Boys waiting for it along the dasher board. Blackhawks will swarm him. Campbell relieves the pressure with Jarmerson as we near the 8-minute mark of the second period. Taves carefully in. He'll fire. That's deadened by Eric Johnson. Boys looping it ahead. Jarmerson giving ground away from McClement. Campbell dangerously in front of his own netminder. Passive forecheck now from the Blues. Morin working wide. Upstate New York native drops it into the corner. Kopetsky, member of the Slovakian Olympic team, lost the handle. Winchester barreling in. One hand on the blade, forced off the angle. Good work by Jarmerson. Cycle game now in effect for St. Louis. Sharp ties up D'Agostini. McClement wriggling loose for Winchester on a stuff attempt. That was blocked. Brad Winchester still with it.
Got some tired defensemen out there for Chicago.
McClement knows that. Centering pass just chipped off the outside by D'Agostini. There's a penalty call up with the Campbell down in the heap and lunging for air. Brower gets a gimme at United Center. 3-1 Hawks. Glad you're enjoying Capital One Hockey Night on Versus with us. Matt D'Agostini in the box for cross-checking, and Eddie, it looked like this against Brian Campbell.
Yeah, the battle down low in there, and a quick little shot right to the rib area on Brian Campbell. Not a good penalty there by D'Agostini. As I mentioned, he had two tired defensemen out there. That line actually had a very good first period for the Blues.
Campbell was gasping for breath for quite a while. Third power play of the period for Chicago.
Not a lot of padding in that area.
Kane, Taves dancing in along with Kopetsky. Rough housing along with Brewer. This one trickles into the corner. Backes with a lift check, not able to clear. Kopetsky far corner to Kane. Straight away, Seabrook. Sharp already has one tonight. Goals in five straight. Kane on the delay. Patrick Kane sweeps it. Two-man game for Taves. And a stop. He scores! Jonathan Taves.
Well, we see this rotation a lot tonight. Kane to Taves. Conklin looking like he's going for a poke check. And from our Jack Daniels goal cam, that's not what happens. Get a great look. It looked like there was a collision right in front of Ty Conklin. His defenseman coming over, Joe, kind of looked like he hit his stick and he kind of slid a little bit, and that opened up just enough space for Taves. First power play of the period, what they try to do, Chicago. Go from Kane to Taves to the far side. And now Taves takes the puck to the net and is rewarded.
Six of his first nine came on the road. He gets one in front of the locals. Great moves by Bickle once again. Big save there for Conklin, keeping it just a three-goal deficit.
Going to go back to the goal. Watch the left part of your screen. There, Eric Johnson goes, and he kicks the stick up of Ty Conklin, and that opens up the bottom of the ice for Taves. You know what Johnson's trying to do? He's trying to prevent that pass, Joe, that we talked about. Instead of sliding more at Taves, he slides, unfortunately, right into his goaltender in his stick. His stick pops up. I don't even know if that puck hit the back of the net.
They all count.
They don't ask how many. Or ask how. Just how many.
Taves into double figures. Long slap shot off the webbing of the glove of Ty Conklin. Agostini sends it on. Sharp there with Petrangelo. Jarmerson sends it wide of the net. Back-to-back power play goals for the Blackhawks, making it a 4-1 lead. Morin with Jackman keeping him at bay. Jarmerson still in the attack territory. Porter on the outlet. D'Agostini working wide. TJ Hensick, a healthy scratch tonight for Davis Payne. Nikita did not keep that in.
Better off to just throw that puck down low. He put his partner, Koliakovo, in a real tough spot. He did a nice job of just giving his team a chance to fight another day.
Poke check by Conklin, alertly from his goal crease. This one's put out of play into the Chicago bench. Hawks opening up. Conklin under siege.
Welcome back to Capital One Hockey Night here on Versus. Hawks ahead 4-1 with head coach Joel Quenneville. Joel, you found that simple approach on the road. Do you feel like you're seeing that translated here on home?
Yeah, not better. First 10 minutes, I think we got better as the game progressed. Got a fortunate bouncer to get a power play goal and came right back with another one. But I like the way we're playing.
All right. Thanks so much, Coach.
Sarah, Coach Q was saying earlier today, work first, skill second at home. That has to be their mantra now.
I think they started that at the end of the six-game road trip. A lot more stopping and starting. The emphasis from the coaches to the players. That all starts 200 feet away from the opponent's goaltender.
Berglund has the lone goal for St. Louis. He's on ice now. The Blues are in the top five when it comes to fewest goals allowed in the NHL this season. They have surrendered four already as we've just passed the midway mark of regulation time tonight in Chicago. Taves to Kane. Shifty move. Stahlberg looking to wrap. Right to the front. Score!
To be able to make plays. Victor Stahlberg, look at the St. Louis Blues. Three players go to Stahlberg. And Patrick Kane, who initially started this play, puck goes right to him. But the stick of Eric Johnson directs the pass perfectly to Patrick Kane. And an explosion here in the second.
Three in the second, four unanswered overall for Chicago, changing the complexion of what was a 1-1 contest, and then the gloves come off. Nick Boynton throwing with B.J. Crombie. Round and round they go. Uppercuts coming. Crombie fought Jake Dowell in the last meeting between these two. Boynton's without his lid. Oh, two big rights at the end. And the linesmen, McKelman and Pancich, get in there.
And great respect there by B.J. Crombie. He knew he stunned the veteran Nick Boynton. And he went in and grabbed him, and the linesman understood that. But right off the faceoff, Crombie looking to change the momentum of the game. In that situation, if you're Chicago, really no need for Nick Boynton to dance the dance in this situation. You're up. A momentum possibly changer. But Boynton, the veteran, answers the call from B.J. Crombie. Both players getting a couple shots in there. Crombie getting the better towards the end. But I really like what Crombie did there, Joe. He knew that he buckled him and probably had a chance once he was kind of trying to get back up. He just went in to give him a big bear hug. Lots of respect there by Crombie.
The second to last punch of that fight was the best one. B.J. Crombie getting the decision. These division games, always physical, always emotional.
You know it's going to charge up the bench for the St. Louis Blues.
St. Louis right back in action tomorrow. They'll play host to Washington. The Blues are 7-0 against Eastern Conference teams. Duncan Keith on the reverse. Veteran defender Jason Cullimore, who will turn 38 on Saturday, gets it ahead for Jack Skilly. Arm in arm with Koliakovo in the corner. 12-minute mark of the second period. It's been a great one for Chicago. They lead 5-1. McDonald finding Boyce. Nikitin to McDonald on the return. Wrister deflected by Seabrook and out of play.
Time now in the second season for Verizon on page 8 of your Blackhawks magazine game program.
Jonathan Taves and Patrick Kane. Season to go. Quite nice.
Yeah, what an Olympics as well for both players. Jonathan Toews being awarded the best forward at the Winter Olympics in Vancouver. Capped it off with being the best player of the Stanley Cup playoffs last season.
In their young careers, though, Edzo, neither of them had done much damage to St. Louis prior to tonight, but both of them are on the board this evening. Four-player scrum. Alex Steen comes away with a biscuit.
The three straight power plays certainly helped.
McDonald in. Fires. That's over the head of Corey Crawford. Porter. And Boys out there with McDonald. Good keep in by Jackman. Brewer winds and drives. That's blocked by Seabrook. Five on five. Play continues. Just over 7 minutes to go. In this middle stanza. Brower starts the breakout for Duncan Keith. A little chip pass. Conklin's going to beat his opposite 29 there. Brian Bickle. Porter takes it off the wall. Chris Porter for Matt D'Agostini. Swivels to get it topside for Jackman. Petrangelo, good moves. Jarmerson able to flush him out. And Jarmerson will clear. Chicago just 14 shots in this contest.
Thought Petrangelo had a chance to shoot that puck right away once he had Thomas Kopecky leaving the middle of the ice, but that just good. That slight hesitation, it closed up right away, as you pointed out, Joe, by the good defensive play there by Jalmerson.
Stalmer can really fly. He zooms in, tries to hit the late guy. Good defensive read by Berglund. He was close by Kane. Petrangelo shakes it ahead, and Sobotka comes charging through center 2-on-2. Sobotka chip and chase. From his knees, no operating space for Berglund. Backus there to help. Feeds Koliakovo, fires. That was rejected by Stallberg.
St. Louis coming a little bit.
Carlo Koliakovo fires. That's fenced out of the air by Campbell. Berglund late in his line shift. Koliakovo keeps it on the board. Sharp takes over. Nikitin gave Kane a bump. Both teams in the middle of a line change. Low angle look at Koliakovo on out for Nikitin. Bolin was in the vicinity. Bickle makes the stick check. Bolin goes the other way. Not going to get through the Blues defense. 3 second period goal for the Hawks. They made it a 5-1 advantage. Steen carving in. Stick save by Crawford. That one may have been headed wide.
Good quick release there by Alexander Steen.
Blues with a regroup through neutral zone. Boys carrying it in. Quick developing 3-on-2. Make it 4. Brewer to the backhand. Stopped. Jailbreak the other way. It's Kane and Scott 2-on-1. Patrick Kane, saucer pass, blocked. Excellent defense by Eric Johnson. 5-1 Hawks. They've done all the celebrating in period two. It's been a happy United Center.
I'm Bill Patrick, coming up on the Verizon Intermission Report. Should the Capitals extend Alex Semin? The guys have some thoughts on that. Plus, we'll break down the moves the Colorado Avalanche have made over the past 2 days. Keith Jones, Brian Engblom, and Mike Milbury join me straight ahead. Okay, Joe.
Okay, Bill. The Avs involved in deals with Boston and Washington in the last 24 to 36 hours. Bill, Keith, Ryan, and Mike Milbury tonight back in Hockey Central.
Full house.
Yes, indeed. Keeping an eye on the other games going on tonight. I'm sure previewing before the night is through that Detroit-San Jose matchup coming up at HP Pavilion. San Jose beat Detroit in 5 in the Western Semis last spring.
Michael Petsky caught a stick from Brad Winchester.
Doubled over at the waist on his way back to the bench. Winchester maneuvers into the offensive zone. Campbell takes care of him there. 4 minutes to go in period two. This was a 2-1 Chicago lead after 20. The Hawks with 3 straight here in the second, along with Eddie Olczyk and Sarah Kustak. I'm Joe Beninati. Capital One Hockey Night on Versus continues from United Center. McDonald opening up on this breakout for the Blues. Skipping his way through center. As the Hawks close ranks, Duncan Keith peppers it off the board. Spickles bottled up. Alexander Steen hearing the instructions from Ty Conklin.
Interference.
Huge hit in the corner. And the Blues want to get after Bolin. Delayed penalty call coming up against Chicago. Conklin will realize that now and race to the bench. Boys, good fake in open ice. 6 attackers on for St. Louis. Back is great relay there. 1 touch. McDonald for Boys on the perimeter. Backus drags it on back for Eric Johnson. This way to Brewer. Boys, delayed penalty against the Blackhawks. 6 skaters on. Johnson fires. That stopped. Rebound for Sobotka. Still possession for St. Louis. Backus. Johnson. Straight away. Sobotka. On a little give and go, Brewer, drive, he scores! Eric Brewer!
Well, a delayed call coming up. Right part of your screen, right there, there's Dave Bolin. Thought Nikitin was gonna get the puck, and then the Blues with the extra attacker. It's keep away, 6 against 5. And this shot from Eric Brewer, traffic in front, upstairs. No chance for Corey Crawford. But what a shift for the St. Louis Blues. I go back to that scrap by B.J. Crombie and Nick Boynton. And since that time, St. Louis has had the better of the play. Remember the chance Alex Steen had, Joe? You called it right off the stick, the thin part of the handle. And the Blues got a little bit of life.
Davis Payne spoke with Sarah Kustak earlier in the day about supporting attack opportunities. Did they ever do it there on that 6-on-5 with a goalie pulled? They trim Chicago's lead back to 3. 2:10 to go, second period. Victor Stahlberg went down in a heap. Petrangelo and Jackman working in back. Backus with a crisp pass out of the grasp of Sobotka. It will allow Campbell to swing. Ryan Campbell down the dashboard off of Taves, who is changing on the fly. D'Agostini in a foot race with Boynton. Matt D'Agostini to the front, just wrong-siding Porter there. Crossed him up. The lefty needed to catch that on his backhand. Dowell with support defensively for Boynton. Nick Boynton, 12th-year pro, able to get it back to center.
Nice play there by Jack Skidley along the board to take a hit, to make a play just to get the puck out into the neutral zone.
McClement charging in with a wrister off the shin pad of Cullimore. Skilly will fetch it in his own zone. Boys playing hard along the boards. Steen was bottled up.
1 minute remaining in the period.
Cullimore, a big man who's persevered through so many injuries and surgeries. Conklin will wander, trying to catch the Hawks in the middle of a change. Steen on a timing play to the front. Seabrook was there. Net knocked from its moorings with 42 to go. Folks, after the final horn sounds, you need to watch NHL Overtime on Versus. It's just getting started then. It's an all-new show. It features tonight's highlights, game breakdowns, and the hockey news that matters. NHL Overtime tonight, 11:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Chock full of good highlights, stories, and commentary. It's appointment television now for hockey fans on Versus.
I gotta set my VCR for that.
Monday through Thursday.
Eight track.
Nice.
Well, we got some old guys in the studio, so you know, we gotta think old school hockey.
Never without a barb for the studio, Eddie Olchek.
Oh, this is
never.
Oh, okay. Selling me down the river.
Whoa. Bill Patrick, hey, Keith Jones, Ryan Engblom, and Mike Milbury tonight, just warming up. 10 seconds left in this period. This one floats into Crawford's glove. Chicago scored the first three of the frame. St. Louis gets one back, and we're done with two in the Windy City. 5-2 for Chicago. After the break, Verizon Intermission Report. We'll get you back to Hockey Central. Bill, Keith, Brian, and Mike will break it all down after these commercial messages. As November comes to an end, temperatures are in the 20s outside of United Center, where Corey Crawford and Ty Conklin are hooking up in a netminders matchup. St. Louis against Chicago. Regular season series to this point split, each team winning on home ice in October. And Chicago hoping to continue that trend. Tonight, a 5-2 leader after two periods of play, including tonight. Chicago plays 10 of its next 13 right here. Off we go with period three. Teams are skating 5-on-5. Victor Stahlberg out there, along with Jonathan Taves and Patrick Kane. Sobotka, Berglund, and Backus on ice for Davis Payne's Blues. Sobotka already with a pair of assists tonight. Had that pass thieved by Kane, forced back to center. Sobotka sends in Berglund, who has one of St. Louis's two tallies this evening. Eric Brewer, the other.
There's Petrangelo, defenseman, getting involved on that keep-in by the St. Louis Blues. Expect them to be a real aggressive finish, real wall that second period. Get the little defenseman to take some chances. Because you're the Blues, you're thinking about, look, probably going to get another power play at some point. If you can cash in there, you're only down by two. I think you got to just chip away. You got to be a little aggressive on the back end.
A pass to the front that's intercepted by Petrangelo. Steen with a good wheels down the wing, and Seabrook will cover him up. Second minute of period three, 5-2 for Chicago. Bickle bumps it for Bolden, and he'll send it hard around. All the way to Steen at center. Cullimore working it back with Nick Boynton. Big collision at center. Jeremy Morin run into by the hard-charging winger there, Brad Winchester. Brewer for Winchester, who's parked at the attacking line. Cullimore stacked him up. Crombean angling in, fires, picked out of there by Crawford. Corey Crawford in goal for Chicago. He'll turn 26 on New Year's Eve. He's making his ninth start, his 10th appearance. He won three times, Eddie, on that trip. Blackhawks took 4 of 6 while the circus was in town. Campbell and Crawford getting their signals crossed. D'Agostini at center. Porter in early, and that's offside against St. Louis. We can send you ringside. Here's Sarah Kustin.
Caught up with Blues assistant coach Scott Mellenby, who said it makes a big difference that they got that late go, giving them a chance to get back in this game. But he said it comes down to getting pucks behind the Hawks defense, taking advantage of that middle quarter of the ice to find quality chances. And Mellenby said they're aware of how potent the Hawks can be, especially when they get this building rolling. So a little coach speak for you. He said he told their guys it all comes down to the first half of this final 20.
Yeah, earlier today it was Eric Johnson saying he wanted to get back to seeing St. Louis be more of a dump and chase team, Sarah. Blackhawks giving a little bit of their own medicine right there. Sobotka and Dowell along the boards. This one squirts free to a backpedaling Campbell. Skilly opens up. Jack Skilly fires, kick out save by Conklin. Blackhawks just 16 shots on goal this evening. Berglund pulls the trigger, off the chest of Crawford, rebound loose. Jackman fires, he whistled it wide. Petrangelo towards the goal, no deflection for Jackman. Petrangelo on the perimeter, content to place it below the goal line. Backus in tight quarters with Sobotka. An aerial to Berglund, swinging a miss. Petrangelo's drive. Score! The Blues are within 2.
You wonder if Joel Quenneville might exercise maybe a timeout here. The Blues have some momentum. Head up all the way by Alex Petrangelo's puck changes directions and beats Corey Crawford. And from our Jack Daniels goal cam, you see the puck change and the reaction from the terrific young defenseman. And the Blues got what they wanted. They got one in the first 5 minutes of this third period.
3:07 to be specific. Blackhawks looked like they were in cruise control on top 5-1. Brewer scored to end the second period summary. Petrangelo igniting the rally for the Blues in period 3. Bickle working the wall. Keeps the cycle humming. As it's chipped away, Brewer on the advance. Brent Seabrook there to collect for Chicago. Sobotka's first ever three-point game in the NHL. He has 3 helpers tonight. 17 in white for St. Louis. Not out there now, but he will be soon. Boys with a blast. It's blocked by Keith, and it's out of play.
The Blackhawks like to congratulate Brzezinovic for being the Bud Light Good Sport designated driver of the game. Please pick up your Blackhawks Good Sport shirt.
Well, for Joel Quenneville. Set his team's defensive zone coverage, Eddie, much better of late. First 10 games of the season, he was not happy with it, one iota.
Yeah, coming back forwards, a lot of flybys, a lot of turning, not stopping and starting, and that's really been an emphasis. We talked about it a little bit earlier. You're not sure, just get back to the middle of the ice, stop and start, and just work yourself out from the middle of the ice in your own zone.
This one floats off of the rink. Koliakovo is trying to get it down the dasher board. As a result, the faceoff comes outside. Alex Petrangelo getting credit for the tally. 20-year-old rookie. Points now in 5 of his last 6 games.
Had a good conversation with him this morning, just being so complimentary of his partner, veteran Barrett Jackman. Just kind of allows him to play to his strengths and know that Jackman's going to have his back in all types of situations, whether it's physical or being aggressive offensively.
Crawford taking no chances. He'll cover up.
I'm going to go back to the goal, and I want everybody to watch. You mentioned Vladimir Sobotka. Look at, he has the puck on his stick, but watch his head, everybody. Look, he looks back to see what are my options. And this puck is actually for Patrick Berglund. John Scott comes over to help. And then the shot by Pietrangelo. What a heads-up play there by Sobotka. Not just getting it and then looking. Once he got it, he looked, had lots of time, and was able to, I mean, he got a little bit of a break because it was bouncing, but he had the right idea in mind. Sometimes you're rewarded with good thoughts and good ideas.
He was acquired, Eddie, in a summertime trade back in June by the Blues from Boston. Remember Sobotka getting some important playoff goals for the Bruins in the playoff series against Montreal back in the spring of 08, I want to say. Here he is in possession of the puck now. Three assists tonight. Lost it there. Jeremy Morin on a takeaway. Taves trying to go outside, inside. Pietrangelo wasn't buying any of it. Backes bullying his way in. David Backes to the front. Hit saved by Crawford.
What a play there by Backes. Not for Chicago. St. Louis has all the momentum. Somebody's got to make a play. It's got to become a chip and chase type of game. Make St. Louis come 200 feet.
You need to tilt the ice the other direction because right now St. Louis is playing downhill and looking very good.
Should be icing.
Backes did dump that in from behind the line and they washed it out.
Corey Crawford left the net. He left the crease.
Good!
Brower tied up at the attacking line. He'll regroup. Almost 6 minutes gone by in the third. Central Division showdown tonight inside of United Center in Chicago. Blackhawks on the lead by two. It was four about a half hour ago. Eric Johnson to Brad Boyes to the net. Stick save. Rebound was juicy there. Boyes scores! Three in a row for St. Louis.
Defenseman getting involved. Eric Johnson right through the middle of the ice. Makes this play. There's Johnson, the defenseman. He gets this puck over to the eventual goal scorer. Brad Boyes does the right thing. Just get it to the net. A mad scramble, and then the man who made the play finds it. Look at the patience and an elevation on Corey Crawford.
Boyes, the Blues Iron Man, gets himself on the board. And Eddie, you thought that Joel Quenneville might have used his timeout sooner than this.
You felt... We felt that St. Louis had the momentum late in that second. So you got an opportunity to go in the locker room, go over video, chat a little bit, talk a little bit. But then all of a sudden, when you see him get another one, as a coach, you weigh, am I sending a signal of panic? You don't really want to do that, but I mean, Joel is absolutely irate right now. And the St. Louis Blues have fought their way back. And I go back when the game was 5-1. The fight by B.J. Crombie and Nick Boynton had seemed to ignite the St. Louis Blues. And now for the last 6 minutes and 2 seconds, the majority of the play has been in the Chicago zone.
In so many instances, the team on the winning end in that fight, in the altercation, normally they would sit there and go, no, there's no reason for me to go. Why bother? I can't win in this situation to a degree. And since that time, it's breathed life into the Blues. Kopetsky working in, throws it right to the goal mouth.
Now the timeout is used in an adjustment. A little bit of a wake-up call saying, hey, look, we had a four-goal lead. Now it's only one.
Oh, the alarm clock is ringing right now in Chicago. 5-4 Hawks.
In Phoenix, November 14th, Davis Payne said Boyes turned things around. He knows how to self-correct. Now he's moving his feet, demanding inside ice, attacking with the puck, and said Boyes has become the scoring threat his team needs, and certainly showed that right here.
Sarah comes with maturity, comes with age. He's a ninth-year pro now. Dangerous Blackhawks in. Backhand, rolling save! Coughlin was huge on Boland. Jarmerson, switch it up. Long blast. Campbell, that was a headhunter off of the glass. Nearing the 7-minute mark of a wild third period now. Three unanswered goals for St. Louis. Has made it 5-4. As the puck's loosened up, there's a penalty call for holding coming. Denny LaRue taking a man with him to the penalty box.
Well, there's that outstanding opportunity for Dave Boland. Beautiful pass there by Brian Bickle. Forehand, backhand, just like the move Patrick Sharp made in that first outstanding stop by Ty Conklin. Remember that stop. Now the Blues shorthanded.
Showing off all the flexibility. Conklin there in his second full season now with St. Louis. Yaroslav Halak backing him up tonight. Marty Turco sitting behind Corey Crawford. At the Chicago end. This one trickles wide. A holding penalty on Nikitin. Special teams are bound to be critical in this close contest now. Kopetsky knocked down. The puck covered up long enough for a whistle. Denny LaRue lost sight of it.
Oh, what a battle down low there by Eric Johnson. Killed off a good 10 or 12 seconds. I believe he was just standing on the puck. The puck sandwiched up along the boards.
Definitely had that skate braced against the dasher. Sharp at the midpoint. Kane on the half wall to the interior. Taves fires. That's blocked. It crawls into the corner. Backus is there. Bookended by a couple of forecheckers. Chicago on the power play for another 1:23.
Big power play for a lot of reasons. Obvious with only a one-goal lead, but momentum as well, Joe, moving forward if they don't score on this power play.
Blackhawks already with two PPGs tonight. They frittered away the first 50 seconds of the advantage. Blues keeping their penalty killers fresh. Plenty of changes. Sharp on the advance. Sends it all the way around. Jeremy Morin, the 19-year-old, getting plenty of quality time now.
He's had a terrific game. Instrumental on the first two goals. Didn't get an assist on either one of them.
Morin leads AHL Rockford in goals at the time of his recall today. Sends it on back. That was intercepted and played clear. McClement doing the honors. Nikitin serves another 30 seconds.
Nice job there by B.J. Crombie to kill a little bit of time just because of having a good active stick and angling.
Boland was straightened up. Barrett Jackman would not allow him into the zone. And Jackman will play keep away. A long lead that's deflected. Jack Skilly on the hop for Chicago. Skilly working wide. Fires! And Conklin will secure that. Folks, it's coming up next. Versus brings you an all-new sports talk show. It features two of the most talkative and talked-about NFL stars, Chad Ochocinco and Terrell Owens. It's the T. Ocho Show. You think you've seen it all, you ain't seen nothing yet. It's next, only on Versus. All of that leading you into NHL overtime tonight.
No slouch, right? I think that was the big phrase this week.
Yes. Seabrook looking for the high deflection there of Patrick Kane.
Nice play there.
Goal, Frank moves on a backhand off the outside. Stahlberg able to free himself up. Kane to the inside. Stick check by Sobotka. Taves measured by Jackman. Kane shortens up on his stick. Hooks it on back for Keith. His blast is blocked. That took a bite out of Sobotka. Backus is a blur down the wing. Caught there by Seabrook. Nearing the midway mark of period three. Blues penalty killers did the job. Keeping the deficit just one. They've scored the last three. Steen knifing in. Berglund trailing the play, and that's blocked off of the ring. The DiGiorno storyline plays out like this.
Well, first career three-assist game for Vladimir Sobotka. Equal his season output with three assists. Now he's got six on the air. And for Jonathan Toews and Patrick Kane, a goal and an assist. Throw Patrick Sharp into that mix as well.
Very much so.
A G and an A.
Chicago just 2 wins in 7 games against division rivals this year. The Blues have also had some difficulties against the Central Division. They dropped 5 of 8. Third of the 6 meetings between these two. The next one will come just after Christmas back at Scott Trade Center. Dowell's wrister was spoiled by Brewer, and that's out of play. 9:49 to go in regulation. Don't you dare move now. We'll get you back to Chicago in a moment.
I'm Bill Patrick, coming up on Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light. Keith Jones, Brian Engblom, and Mike Milbury are back. We'll have complete post-game coverage and analysis, plus highlights from around the league, including an incredible finish in Toronto. Stay with us immediately following the game, whenever that is, Joe.
Looking forward to it, Bill. Good news for Tampa Bay fans and Simon Gagné fans in particular that you will spell out for us.
That's the way you come back in the lineup.
Big time. We are enjoying a wild one in Chicago. First game back for the Blackhawks after a long road swing. Kane spins to the high slot and fumbled it. Chicago was in complete control of this game. They had a 5-1 advantage. St. Louis has definitely wriggled off the hook, and it's 5-4 right now. McDonald slams on the brakes, looking for that deflection there. Turned away. Crawford made the stop on Steen. Stallberg. One sweep, another will dump it in. Line changes on the fly for both squads. You see Petrangelo deliberately out of his own end. Petrangelo, one of the goal scorers for St. Louis. In this third, long wrister, Crawford has it, and he'll melt it at the top of the crease.
Well, the St. Louis Blues going hard to the net. Simple play. Berglund pulls on the brakes and then shoots this puck. Little bit of a rebound. Bolin there, Campbell there. David Back is looking for any kind of a rebound.
Crawford, Edzo, is 95% the save percentage department in his last 4 starts. All of them wins. Neither goalie helping his save percentage numbers this evening. This one's into the safety netting for a whistle.
I think there might be a penalty here. Might be a delay of game by Dave Bolin off the faceoff.
Referees are bringing everybody with them to neutral zone.
Yeah, I like what referee Denny LaRue is doing here. He's visiting with Brian Pantsich and Andy McKelman. Puck is in midair, and then the stick of Dave Bolin. Yes, the right call being made by referee Denny LaRue. In the defensive zone, you knock the puck over the glass and ends up hitting the meshing in behind. But I like what LaRue did. Make sure he talked to Brian Pachmera, the other referee. He visited with the linesman, and I like that a lot.
They got it right.
Yep.
St. Louis power play looking for the equalizer. Power play has been better on the road than it has been at home, where St. Louis has been oh so good this year. They were the last team to lose in regulation at home. Crawford the save. Looks behind him, then he finds it in the glove off the tip-in try.
Nice job there by Alex Steen on the point. Head up all the way. Not a big roof tickler, not a big slap shot. Just wrist it at the net. I think that puck went off of Brent Seabrook. And then Corey Crawford is able to track it from right to left. It stops. Little bit of a rebound. David Back is looking for something juicy right in front, but a nice idea there by Steen.
Backus lost the draw. Boys pin Seabrooks, then strips him of the puck. Lays it on top, Petrangelo will keep it in. Steen serves it on back, slapper D'Agostini. That was rejected in front, it hit the screener. It was Boys at the top of the paint, and the Hawks are able to get it out. Steen turns right back into the action. On the wing for Boys. Button hook to the boards. Hard hit coming from Seabrook. He jammed Winchester down. Petrangelo maneuvers into a better shooting lane. Clapper coming on the one-timer. That was weakened as Boys broke his stick. Short-handed situation for Chicago. Another 50 seconds. 7:45 to go in regulation time. The Blues have battled back to make this a one-goal game. Sharp and Winchester there. Campbell swatted at it. Didn't get good wood on it. Johnson tied up by Taves. He'll send it out. It's Sharp one-on-one. Patrick Sharp hesitates. Good defense by Koliakovo. Sharp ragging more precious time away from the St. Louis power play, which exists for only 18 more seconds. Berglund is parked on the boards. Interchange play with McDonald. Winchester for Koliakovo. Dowell comes to get him. Campbell is there to support. Didn't get it out. Johnson walks in and fires. That's blocked. One-handed to the top of the crease again, where Crawford was stacked up. Boland's out of the sin bin. He'll play it on back. 6:50 to go in a wild one in Chicago.
Talk about the struggles of the Blackhawk penalty kill the last five games. Goals and five straight given up. Seven in total. Big penalty kill there. Outstanding work by Corey Crawford and his defenseman blocking a few opportunities for the Blues.
Duncan Keith will get a lot of ice time down the stretch. He always does. Crombean's pass was intercepted by Kopetsky. Stahlberg works in. He's got Kane the trailer. Victor Stahlberg works wide. Fires! And hit the post! Rebound score! Patrick Kane!
Well, you talked about the speed of Victor Stahlberg. He forces his puck to get to the net, and it finds its way between the blocker and the right hip of Ty Conklin off the post, and then right over to Patrick Kane, who sees this puck. Eric Brewer's not able to see this puck because he's looking at Kane, and then the quick stick of Kane puts it into the wide-open net.
Patrick Kane, who had one goal in his last 13 meetings straight up against the Blues, has two tonight. And the cushion is back to two. And it's Bedlam inside of United Center, where the Blackhawks are under 500 this season. Two teams separated by 1 point in the Central Division standings. Chicago one better than St. Louis. Eric Johnson carrying it through center. Sobotka scampers down the wing, getting help from Berglund. Bickel turns him away. Boland there as well. This is whistled down for an offside against St. Louis. A high-scoring affair, just the way Patrick Kane likes it, with the NHL on Versus. Chicago Blackhawks are back at home and back in front by at least two. Patrick Kane gnawing on that mouth guard. A three-point performance for him this evening. Two goals and an assist. We have 5:35 to go in regulation time. Boys, McDonald, and Steen out there now. Kane was nearly away to the races after intercepting that pass. McDonald cruising in, poke check by Seabrook. Patrick Kane, two on two the other way with Stahlberg. Kane fires off the pipe. Ty Conklin will hate that last goal. It was one of those shots that leaked through the goalie. Now we get some tough stuff in the corner.
Victor Stahlberg's the man on the ice. Looks like he got pushed from behind after the shot by Patrick Kane goes off the post. And he's going to need some medical attention. There's the shot. There's Stahlberg going hard to the net. He's going to work himself into the corner. And there he's pushed from behind. And Mike Gapski, the head medical trainer. There's the top of your screen.
Good sign for Blackhawks fans. Stahlberg up on his own power.
I believe that was Andy McDonald that pushed Victor Stahlberg.
And McDonald was getting a scolding, a little more than that. A as he's come all the way to the penalty box. Our Bud Light Impact player this evening belongs to the Blackhawks. Patrick Kane is the man. All over the score sheet. And pretty accurate, his two tallies on just three shots. We revisit the two from number 88.
This one to give the Hawks a two-goal cushion here in the third. Up 5-1 at one point. The Blues made it 5-4, and then the shot by Stahlberg off the post. Kane with the wide-open cage.
Patrick Kane's in the box. Referee LaRue is giving a lecture at the referee's crease to both Backes and Taves. Davis Payne will require an explanation. Checking the scoreboard and seeing that his gang has just a bit more than 5 minutes left to make another spirited rally. Shots on goal unofficially 24-20, favor of St. Louis. As they continue to get the boys in line, the live action resumes.
An extra penalty to Andy McDonald being served by Chris Porter. The reason that the faceoff comes outside is because all five players, the defensemen, came in from their defensive position into the scrum, and that's one of the ways the faceoff can come out on a power play.
Duncan Keith and the Blackhawks working after the boarding call. Patrick Sharp sets up shot. Sharp feeds for Kopetsky. Bang, bang, Taves! Stopped by Conklin. Sharp on the exterior to Keith. Switch it up for Seabrook. Duncan Keith brings it to Sharp. Winds in, fires, pad save, Conklin. Kopetsky, great work, and Bloodhound looking for that rebound, and then Seabrook jammed it wide. Keith settles in, drives one that stopped, in tight, score! Kopetsky to Taves, it's 7-4.
Such an important part. St. Louis not able to regain the puck after the Taves faceoff. That shot by Duncan Keith actually broke the stick of Patrick Berglund. And then Thomas Kopetsky finds it. Taves gets inside position on Eric Brewer. And he buries it. Wide open, Ed Eagles top shelf. But a fortunate bounce there for the Blackhawks. Off the broken stick of Patrick Berglund. But what a play there by Thomas Kopetsky.
A seven-goal explosion inside the madhouse. It's 7-4. Three power play goals for Chicago tonight. As Petrangelo serves it out wide. D'Agostini with the offensive zone entry. Crom being softly to the goal. Crawford has that covered long enough for the whistle. Chicago's power play 3-for-5 tonight.
They scored him different ways. Remember, the Taves goal is his first one. Just taking the puck to him himself. You get a point shot there from Keith. Great play by Kopetsky. Variation by the Blackhawks tonight.
St. Louis penalty kill, Eddie, had been pretty good. They only allowed one power play goal in the last five games prior to this evening. But the dam is broken. It's 7-4 for Chicago.
Another power play goal is that lucky bounce when Warren dumped the puck in. And Troy Brower had a wide open net with Ty Conklin in behind his net.
That's when you know you're living right. Ryan Campbell, an expert skater, to say the least. For Stahlberg. Campbell gets it in gear for Jarmerson. That one jumped his tape. Hawks are going in reverse.
Go back to that penalty kill by the Blackhawks. Bowling off for delay of game. Huge kill. Gave him some confidence. Then Kane comes right back and gives him a two-goal cushion.
Crawford watching Keith take over. Bodies are flying in this third period. Board rattling kind of game. Sobotka's blast rejected by Keith. Brewer's drive is high at knuckle dunk. Just started to roll as he pulled the trigger. Eric Johnson waiting for his guys to get onside, but not long enough. This is offside against St. Louis. Huge offensive night for many of the Blackhawks, especially Thomas Kopetsky, a four-pointer. Guy who came on strong after the Olympic Games last year. Joel Quenneville loved his game after the Olympic break and through the Stanley Cup run.
And was on a line with Jonathan Toews and Marian Hossa for the majority of the latter part of the Stanley Cup final.
Another good bout along the boards. Jeremy Morin and Chris Porter, nose to nose. Body blows from the youngster. Linesmen have seen enough.
Right, both these guys have had terrific games. Lawrence had a little bit more ice time than Chris Porter, but thought Porter might have been one of the better forwards in the first period for the St. Louis Blues. And mentioned Jeremy Morin, instrumental on the first two goals, being physical and finally getting that assist when the puck hit the glass and ended up on the stick of Troy Brower in the second period.
Porter, another guy who came through Shattuck St. Mary's High School in Minnesota, then went to the University of North Dakota. You mentioned earlier that he was originally a Chicago draft pick. Squaring off with Jeremy Morin, who had a terrific training camp. He was one of the last guys sent down from Joel Quenneville's squad, who's come home from a long road trip and scored goals with a vengeance tonight. Well, 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 Big John Scott and Cam Jansen are on the ice.
I think Denny LaRue is just going to say, you know what? Somebody's going to the box.
John Scott making his way to the penalty box in the Boo Birds. Awaken. Cam Jansen is following.
Is he giving him unsportsmanlike conduct? Both jumped on the ice together.
Shall we dance? Shall we dance? Let's wait till the play starts again so they don't throw the book at us. And instead, the referees fire a preemptive shot there. 2:51 left. It's a three-goal lead for Chicago. A game that's been on the seesaw, back and forth. Petrangelo guns this one, score! Another change of direction, it's 7-5.
Boy, that lateral movement by Petrangelo. Puck's low to high, head up all the way, and just fires this puck. Corey Crawford looking for it. Another one elevated by the St. Louis Blues. Puck is low, yeah, tipped and then redirected. I think that changed direction twice. Low shot. Traffic in front, and the puck ends up going upstairs when Crawford is going down.
Backus is always a dependable guy cruising through that shooting lane, either to take the eyes away from the goalie or redirect that shot. In either way, at 17-21, it's still a hockey game. Campbell able to keep in. Kane to Toews. Both of those guys on the board twice. Backus to the rescue for St. Louis.
Here's Chicago. You don't let any guy in white jersey get in behind you.
This is a 3-on-2. Petrangelo to the front, just missing for Sobotka. Jarmerson. Campbell. And away. Sharp returns it to Campbell. Fidgets wide. Sends one off of Eric Johnson, 1:38 to go. We'll keep our eyes on Ty Coughlin, see when he'll be lifted for the extra skater. A whistle here and an offside against Chicago. Folks, after the final horn sounds, keep your eyes open for NHL Overtime on Versus. They're just getting started. It's an all-new show. It features tonight's highlights, game breakdowns, and the hockey news that matters. NHL Overtime tonight, 11:30 Eastern Time.
And anticipate once St. Louis gets the puck over the red line in control, Constant's got to make a beeline for the bench.
Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light, will follow us. Bill Patrick, Keith Jones, Brian Engblom, and Mike Milbury tonight. Back at Hockey Central. Sharp gets the middle and fires off the glove of Coughlin. Rebound back to Sharp. Couldn't finagle his way past McDonald. Coughlin is on his way to the bench. Just over a minute to go in regulation. Andy McDonald hits the brakes. It's steamed to a backhand. He shuffles wide. Backus will hustle and keep it in. His wrister was spoiled. It'll force the Blues to retreat. Steen waiting. Working wide for Boys. Answered there by Seabrook. Steen, one-timer deflected. There's a penalty call coming. There was a takedown in front. It's going to be against Chicago. Oliakovo gets it deep. Blackhawks wisely don't touch it right away. There are 33.1 seconds to go after this interference call.
I believe it's going to be on Duncan Keith.
Chicago number two, 2 minutes in Fairfax.
Now remember, Chicago has already used its 30-second timeout. Davis Payne is likely to burn one here.
Well, the middle of your screen, two in red, on 26 on white. So the dry erase board out. Face-off so imperative. That'll be a quick strike. Can't look to set anything up. And for Chicago, it's the face-off win. The route you take if you lose. And defenseman, if the puck is pulled back, anticipating it will be Jonathan Toews for the Blackhawks. How that puck is moved around the boards to give yourself a chance to get it in the neutral zone.
Ty Coughlin hoping his mates can get him off the hook. Corey Crawford trying to secure a win for Joel Quenneville. When we spoke with Crawford earlier in the day, he made a very interesting point. He said he couldn't tell if a team created lots of traffic for a goalie from watching on TV or from sitting on the bench. I asked him if St. Louis was the type that would drive him crazy with traffic, and he said, you know, I won't know until tonight. They've been around his net a lot. Six attackers on. Berglund, Boys, McDonald out there. Backus has a four-point night. Petrangelo and Steen, all in white. Over the head of Petrangelo and on down. Chicago can take hot shots at the empty net. There's no fear of icing because they're shorthanded.
Good face-off win by Jake Dowd, not Jonathan Toews.
Pointing towards the net. Jonathan Toews, a guy who's won more total face-offs than anyone in the league this year. Steen spins into the O-zone. Boland's there to send him away, and just wide of the goal. 5 seconds now, four. Chicago comes home from the long road swing and prevails by the final count of 7-5.